UFC 229 was one of the biggest events in UFC history. So many good fights took place, so many different knockouts, so many different highlights, but one fight stole the show from everybody else, and just like expected, it was the main event between Khabib Nurmagomedov and Conor McGregor.
Now tuned into the greatest.
Now, a lot of people think it is Drake's fault that McGregor got annihilated like that. But Drake fans, you can take a deep breath because it's not his fault. And I'm here to tell you what exactly happened, whose fault it is, and what led to this brawl and Khabib jumping over the fence and attacking McGregor's training staff after just beating the brakes out of Conor McGregor. Now, if you don't know, in UFC 29 main event, Khabib Nurmagomedov tapped Conor McGregor out. I mean, he just annihilated Conor McGregor. Conor McGregor did not win a single round, but besides that, he did not even land at least three powerful shots. People say that Khabib only wrestled, but Khabib wrestled him for the first few rounds, and then in the third round, he boxed him. He said, you know what, I'll go to your game and I'll do what you do. And outboxed Conor McGregor. He outpunched him, he out-attacked him. He was a clear winner, even if he went to decision. But he did not go to decision because Conor McGregor tapped out. And after the fight, Khabib Nurmagomedov jumped the cage and straight jump drop kick Conor McGregor's coach. And while that was happening, Khabib's manager was trying to stop the thing. McGregor punched him, and two boys from Khabib's camp jumped in the octagon and started beating up on McGregor. Now the whole mayhem broke loose, you know, almost a brawl started. So let's talk about why Khabib is so passionate about this. What led to this? Now Conor McGregor thought this was gonna be just like another fight. He's gonna go in there, talk a lot of smack, win his fight, sign his check, say some humble words, you know, give props to the other guy, and walk out.
Next question.
Gentlemen, Khabib, assalamu alaikum, and Conor, congrats on proper 12.
Thank you, sir.
Could we get an official prediction on the fight?
You cannot say assalamu alaikum and congrats about whiskey. Ooh, slap him then. Do something about it. What are you gonna do about that? Is that the disrespect in you? Do something then, I'll just shut your mouth. Fucking fool you. Backwards cunt.
Thanks, Conor.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate that. Assalamu alaikum, alada.
From the two of you, could we get an official prediction on the fight?
Domination. His head bouncing off the canvas. All his pony talk is gonna be fucking put on blast October 6th.
Do you have a round in mind?
As long as it takes. I believe one. He's a glass jaw. My Chechen friends, the Vainagi soldiers, they told me that they have chicken jaws in Dagestan. And I believe...
But no, this is Khabib Nurmagomedov. This is a guy that does not care about money, does not care about all this. He just cares about legacy. He said it before, said, I only care about legacy. Now, Conor McGregor disrespected Khabib in so many ways. Now, first of all, let's go back in time where Khabib and his crew confronted Artem Lobov. Conor came in, threw a dolly at the bus, broke the glass, you know, injured a couple of the fighters and had a chance to ruin their career. I mean, it was that bad. So in a press conference, Conor McGregor disrespected Khabib in every way possible. Religion, I mean, talked about his dad, called him a rat, called his manager a terrorist. I mean, just made fun of him, called him a backwards cunt. I mean, listen, any way you could disrespect him, he did. All Khabib said was, I will see you in the octagon, October 6th. And that's exactly what he did. Now, let me just show you guys a quick video of all the trash talking that took place before. Oh, and keep in mind, Conor said, if you got out the bus, I would have killed you. He said, thank God you didn't, I would have killed you. So let's rewind and look what all took place and what caused this.
Versus Khabib Nurmagomedov. It's arguably the biggest fight in UFC history. Tensions between the two have been rising.
after McGregor attacked a UFC team bus, allegedly targeting Khabib in April.
He's going to jail.
Just tell me where, and that's it. Why you need to come here? Show up like you want to fight or something like this. Send a message, hey, come here, this place, and that's it.
And the talk leading up to the fight has been all about the contrasting style of the fighters and their claim to the lightweight belt. But there's been little mention of the racial slurs McGregor has hurled at Khabib.
You!
And this is not the first time. He referred to Floyd Mayweather's bodyguards as monkeys.
Oh, juicehead monkey, juicehead monkey.
And asked Floyd to dance for him.
Dance for me, boy. Dance for me, son. Dance for me.
He fired racial slurs at Jose Aldo.
I own this town. I own Rio de Janeiro. I would invade his favela on horseback and kill anyone that was not fit to walk. But we are in a new time, so I'll whoop his ass in July.
Now he's on to Khabib. Throughout their first press conference, McGregor was seen taunting, mocking, and trying to intimidate Khabib.
Yeah, shut your mouth!
Then he decided to promote his new alcoholic beverage and offered a drink to Khabib, who's a Muslim and doesn't drink.
I'm gonna go like I last fight.
Happy birthday!
Like, I don't drink.
Why don't you drink?
I don't drink.
Why don't you drink?
I never drink.
I'll tell you, some booze at parties.
I never drink.
You're mad backwards. You're dead when I get me hands on you, do you hear me?
I never.
Dead.
I never drink this
all drink
shit.
At me.
He also called Khabib's manager a terrorist.
Shut your mouth, Ali Abdelaziz, my terrorist.
Ali.
Terrorist snitch.
Ali.
This is what Khabib had to say about the situation.
Of course, he tried to promote this fight, make money, hey, but like end of the day, you have to think about the young generation, hey.
Okay.
I want to be good one.
Now, for those of you that are saying, oh, you know, Khabib acted wrong. Now, you might be right. I don't condone violence. I don't condone things like that. But there's a certain amount of respect, especially for people from where Khabib is from. That is not acceptable. You can never disrespect somebody's father like that. You can never call somebody a terrorist, you know, disrespect his religion and then expect no consequences in return. So Conor McGregor has done worse. He has jumped out of the octagon before. He has spilled stuff on people. He has spit on people before. I mean, he that guy threw a dolly at a bus, broke the bus window and injured fighters before the fight night. I mean, that could be career ending. Like, that could have been career defining fight for them. So he's done things worse. So when Conor does it, oh, that's just Conor being Conor. Now when Khabib does it, oh, that's a big deal. So we need to have some equality there. And Khabib lost it. And yes, that was not the right thing to do. He should have controlled his emotions, but easier for us to stay outside, you know, looking in. And just like DC said, it's a different culture. For you to understand the passion Khabib has, you gotta understand their culture first. I mean, Khabib is literally a fighter and he's in it for glory. He said, I don't even want Conor. I don't want the money fight. I want GSP, I want Tony Ferguson. And now, I believe he could focus on them. Conor later on tweeted and said that he would like to have a rematch, but let me tell you something. I personally don't think Conor deserves a rematch. Now, if you're gonna rematch, you usually rematch because the fight was close. You know, somebody had a chance. This fight was never close. Just because he's McGregor doesn't mean he deserves a rematch. Just because he talks a lot does not mean he deserves a rematch. Now, I believe Khabib should fight Tony Ferguson next. I believe he should fight GSP and whoever falls in line. Maybe Nate Diaz. I mean, just whoever. But I think Conor deserves a rematch? Absolutely not. Conor needs to go back, you know, get his mojo back, fuck up all guys, and then come contend for the title again. But as of right now, no way. He was never close. He never lead in the fight. He never even had a good strike. I mean, this is a wrestler outboxing the guy that is known for boxing. And Khabib is 27-0, or I mean, you could say 28-0 after, you know, the coach. And before I go, I want to show you guys a funny clip. And it don't change.
Go to sleep. You're fitting to die. You're the
pocket that I'm bleeding.
You shouldn't be talking shit.
No, my sunshine, no pain when it's coming. Won't you give yourself to me? Give it all. I just wanna see.
Wait, I'm almost done.
I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see.
Oh my god, you don't have to gaze on the
stars.
I don't know if you thought that was funny, but it made my day. I thought that was funny. But overall, it was a great event. Definitely money's worth. If you paid for the fight, you definitely got every penny worth it. I mean, entertainment, social media is still going up. Khabib Nurmagomedov and Conor and UFC both still trending the next day. People are still talking about it. It was one for the history books. Very entertaining. Now, I might sound a little biased. Yes, I am a Khabib fan, but I also respected Conor until this, you know, fight and the press conferences and stuff. And yeah, you can say, oh, you know, that's just what he does. There's a line, you know, there's always a line. And Conor has been known to cross the line. And, you know, some people are about it. You know, some people are in it for the money. Some people really want to put their hands on you. And they did that. You wanted this energy, and they matched you with this energy. Now, there was rumors that Khabib might get his title taken away. No, that probably won't happen. I might get a big fine. And the guys that were arrested for jumping Conor, Conor didn't press charges, so they released him from jail. Now, a lot of people say, oh, that's really dope what Conor did. But to be honest, Conor not pressing charges doesn't really mean anything, because he has done things worse. And, you know, nobody pressed charges and they let him off the hook. But overall, I don't think any serious consequences will happen to Khabib. So let me know what you guys think. Please subscribe. I'm back on this channel. I haven't posted in a long time. I'm gonna do reaction videos. I'm gonna do sport commentaries. I'm gonna do music reaction videos. I'm gonna educate people on stuff like how to make extra money on the side. I'm gonna educate people how to get scholarships, you know, how to get into university. Just, you know, self-made bosses type videos, man. Just trying to educate and help. Please subscribe, hit the notification bell. Let us know in the comment section below, what do you think about the fight? What did you think about the event? Do you believe McGregor deserves a rematch? Let us know. And until next time, peace.